About your Bible. It is inspired. It is God's word. Jesus said the scriptures cannot be broken, John 10:35. And for centuries, Christians have believed that all scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfectly furnished unto every good work. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul, I read in Psalm 19. We have been born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God that liveth and abideth forever, Peter tells us in his first epistle. Without faith it is impossible to please God. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, writes St. Paul, inspired of the Holy Ghost. These facts are obvious. The Bible claims to be the word of God. 2,500 times in the Old Testament it's recorded that God spake and God said. Jesus declared that the Bible is the word of God. He said that not one jot or tittle shall pass away till all is fulfilled. And across the centuries, the Bible has demonstrated its power to heal and guide and cleanse and save. My text today is Isaiah chapter 46, verses 9 and 10. It is God's challenge to everyone who doubts his existence or his power. Oh, there are thousands of proofs of God. Every flower and tree and sunset shouts at us that God is real. But the conclusive proof for every honest inquiry is given in my text today. I am God, and there is none like me, God says, declaring the end from the beginning, and the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure. This is God's challenge to every skeptic in the world. God writes history in advance. God knows the future. Nothing ever takes him by surprise. So God says to you and me, search the universe. You will never find anyone to compare with me. I alone know the future. Well, our text, of course, is all about prophecy and its testimony to God's existence and to the miraculous nature of the Bible. Who can foretell the future? Nostradamus? Gene Dixon? Their prophecies are about as accurate as flipping a coin in the air. Are you convinced that fortune tellers can tell the future? If they did, they would all be multimillionaires by playing the stock markets. Only one knows the end from the beginning. Satan doesn't know, you don't know, I don't know. Only the God of the Bible has 20/20 vision. As far as the future is concerned, he alone knows what will be tomorrow. Let me give you some Bible examples. Example number one, Daniel wrote that 463 years would elapse from Nehemiah's rebuilding of the walls of Jerusalem at the decree of King Artaxerxes until the Messiah would come. Did it happen? It's a fact of history. Exactly 483 years elapsed from the rebuilding of the walls of Jerusalem until Jesus rode into Jerusalem in fulfillment of Zechariah chapter 9 verse 9, offering himself formally to the nation as their promised Messiah. There was no way it could be just a coincidence. Example number two, Psalm 22 pictures Jesus Christ on the cross. But Psalm 22 was written 1,000 years before our Savior died. We learn that he was sold for silver, that he was betrayed by a friend, that his hands were pierced, that they gambled for his garments. Tell me, how could they have foretold that 1,000 years before it happened? Fulfilled prophecy is ironclad proof of a living and all-knowing God. I challenge you to examine the prophecies of the Bible and then to believe. Example number three, Isaiah 53 prophesied that Christ would make his grave with the rich and the wicked. He would die, but then he would prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord would prosper in his hand. After 800 years, that prophecy was fulfilled in specific detail. This is history. Jesus died, was buried. On the third day, he rose from the dead in the power of endless life. The prophecy was fulfilled. Example number four, Isaiah chapter 11, verse 11, an amazing prophecy that your generation and mine has seen. The Lord, I'm reading, the Lord shall set his hand the second time to recover the remnant of his people. He will gather the outcasts of Israel, the dispersed of Judah, from the four corners of the earth back to their own land upon the mountains of Israel. Well, you are a witness. For 2,500 years, Jerusalem was trodden down of the nations, but the Jews survived in spite of pogroms and holocausts. We called them the wandering Jews, strangers on the earth without a homeland. But today, Israel exists as a sovereign nation in defiance of all the precedents of history. It couldn't happen, but it did, just as God said it would happen. Fulfilled prophecy shouts to everyone with ears to hear that God lives and that the Bible is a miracle book and that God rules in the affairs of men. Now let me give you example number five. Jesus said, Matthew 16 verse 18, I will build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Consider the odds against that happening. After all, thousands have been martyred in Roman amphitheaters and on killing fields by our Lord's enemies. And there have been the attacks of the academics and the hypocrisy of carnal leaders and the competition of world religions, the hatred of Satan, the opposition of science, falsely so-called, the fanaticism of professed friends. But in spite of all of that, our Lord's prophecy holds good. Jesus said, this gospel shall be preached in all the world for a witness to all nations, and then shall the end come, and it is happening. Millions upon millions in every nation around the world bear witness to the power of the gospel. Oh yes, the Bible said that many will depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, and that is happening. The Bible said that in the last days, scoffers will come, saying, where is the sign of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they did from the beginning of the world. And that too is happening. But Christ is building his church. Jesus said it would happen, and it is. God presented the world with a challenge. If you can find any God who can foretell the future other than the God of the Bible, worship that God. If you can find any book other than the Bible that writes history in advance, well, follow that book. The fact is that there is no God like Jehovah, and there is no book like the Bible, and there is no Savior like the Christ of the cross, who died and the third day rose again in the power of endless life and ever lives to make intercession and is able to save to the uttermost all who come unto God by him. Dear friend, someday you and I will stand before God. If we haven't even examined the Bible, if we haven't even asked the hard questions, if we haven't even examined the proof of God in fulfilled prophecy, what are we going to say to him when we meet him? Now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation. Now the Savior stands at the door of your life knocking. Will you let him come in? Will you trust in him? Faith is not a leap into the dark. Faith is just believing on the basis of conclusive evidence there is a God, there is a Savior, there is a heaven, there is a hell, there's a cross, and God loves you and wants to bless you.
Pastor Barber today. Please watch for Faith to Live By again next Sunday at this same time on this same station.